I was looking at how to make aluminium oxide from aluminium metal, and I did not find really any simple reaction, when it should be simple. I mean, you are oxidizing metal, so how hard can it be? Okay, so here's what I came up with. You will need some glass or stainless steel container. Fill half of its volume with almost boiling hot water. Then add sodium hydroxide, about 3 grams per liter should be about right. The sodium hydroxide will contaminate your product with sodium ions a little bit, so keep that in mind. Then you have to add some aluminium foil. The aluminium foil should be cut into squares and it should be easy to separate these squares into solution. Otherwise the aluminium will not react with the sodium hydroxide quickly enough and it will basically not turn into powder and you will have to crush it. You can see already some small particles forming. I don't think that this is sodium aluminate. At least not yet. Ideally this reaction does not require any outside source of heat and you will end up with powder. And with big enough container you probably don't even have to stir things up. You would think that the sodium hydroxide would be consumed during this reaction, but I guess that what happens in the water is that the sodium aluminate is actually quite free to jump from aluminate to the hydroxide form. Here you can see that the glass will be stained during this reaction, and I am putting some pieces here to further examine the staining because it's quite interesting on its own. At some point you will get some pieces of aluminium foil on the bottom of the container, and these pieces will be covered by, I guess, aluminium hydroxide and will not react very fast enough. However, they will produce some hydrogen bubbles and these will collect under this crust of the aluminium hydroxide basically. Once enough hydrogen will be collected, it will release this bubble at once. But until that point, hydrogen will be trapped and it will increase the volume significantly. So I ended up splitting this batch into two containers and carry on. When the reaction is over, you will end up with something like this. I say the reaction is over, but you can clearly see that the container on the right side releases some hydrogen still. If you can boil this for another hour or so, it would be really nice. The final step is converting aluminium hydroxide to aluminium oxide. This can be done simply by heating the slurry to about 200 degrees or higher. I have done that in the tray like this and it's quite corroded, so I covered that with aluminium, which wasn't really a good idea as you can see because it ate it. So after drying I ended up with product that looks like this. It is obviously contaminated with aluminium foil, but this is from the tray that I baked it in. However, I have seen some pieces of aluminium that are obviously from the reaction itself, which I assume are from the container on the right side, but this can be screened, so not big deal. Now for this glass staining, I mean it cannot be really dissolved with anything. The interesting thing about it is that it can grow to extreme dimensions, about 0.5 millimeter. To get rid of it you can use very small amount of hydrochloric acid. It won't dissolve the staining, but it will liberate it, basically. Okay, so that seems to be all that I wanted to say here, so see you next time.